Hello, I wanted to show you today how to create an idle timer or to check for user interactivity in a React app. So this is a problem I came across today at work, and I wanted to show my solution. So I have a quick, I set up a quick little application here to demonstrate what I'm talking about. So let me refresh here, and you can see down in the console here, I'm looking at local storage. And I'm having something, a key set called expire time. And so this is set to 10 seconds ahead of the last user inactivity, or the last user activity, excuse me. So whenever the user does anything, that means clicking, mouse down. I think that I have four things set right now to watch for, which is mouse move, key down, click, and and scroll, I think. So those. Any of those four actions happen, which pretty much encompasses almost all the actions a user can take. The expire time updates to 10 seconds from that point. So you can see it updating down there at the bottom. Now, if I stop, it's going to stop updating, and in about 10 seconds, up here in the top left, logged in true is going to turn into logged in false. So after about 10 seconds of inactivity, the user is going to be logged out, and that's just the case that that's what I use the an activity timer for in this example. And then also, perfect. So you see it changed to logged in false. Come over here to console and log out. So let me show you the inner workings of this. It's pretty simple here and it's a pretty small app. So whatever, you can do this in whatever components you want. I would typically do this in something like a layout or at the base of the the root component, depending on where the user is logged in, where they're not. So I would do this in layout typically, and that way the user only sees this layout, the specific layout, if they're logged in, and then this will not run if they aren't logged in. So first you're going to import use effect, and I import use state here just to display the login if the user is logged in. So this is obviously not needed, but the use effect is the only one that's actually required for this application here. So let's come down into the app component. So I set the state for logged in and I set it to true. So on refresh, or when you refresh the page, this user is going to be logged in. Now we're going to have two functions here. One is called check for inactivity and one is update expire time. And they do exactly what they are named for. So check for inactivity. First, what it's going to do is it's going to grab the expire time from local storage, which is basically when was the last user activity plus 10 seconds. So it's going to grab the expire time here from local storage. You have to do local storage dot get item and grab your expire time and then set it to a variable. And then you come down right below it and it's going to compare the expire time to the current date, or date dot now, which is the current time. So if expire time is less than the current time. So basically, if the current time has passed what the expire time is supposed to be, then you're going to log out the user. And in my case, that just means console login log out and set the logged in state to false. And so basically this right here inside this if is where you're going to do all the logging out or whatever you're going to do with an activity. Maybe you want to send a notification that says, hey, you've been inactive for 10 seconds, whatever, right? That's all going to be done right here. And so I'll show you where we use this function in a minute. Now come down to update expire time. Again, this updates the expire time in local storage. So what you're first going to do is you're going to set, this is another function that's not being called right away. I'll show you where it's called down here. But what it is going to do is set a new expire time. So maybe this wasn't the most efficient variable naming because it's the same as the local storage name. But I said const expire time, so this is a new variable. Say date.now, so the current time plus 10,000 milliseconds. So this is 10 seconds. What I actually used while building the application that I had to use this for, I did something like that. It was supposed to be one day. So I think that's right, 36,000 milliseconds. Or 36,000 seconds. But regardless, you can do that math. It's 1,000 times the number of seconds that you want to wait until the user is logged out from the last activity. I'm gonna set this actually 5 seconds here so that you can so we can see it happen in quicker time on the front end here. So once you have this expire time set, you're gonna go ahead and set it in local storage. It's that simple. You just put the new time in local storage, it'll overwrite the old one. Perfect. So that means that you're now setting the update, you're now setting the expire time to 5 seconds or whatever amount of time you want from the current time that you call that function. So the first use effect here is going to, actually, you know what? Let's take a look at the second use effect first. It doesn't really matter which one, but we'll take a look at the second one. So this use effect is going to be set for detecting activity from the user and updating the expire time. So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to this is going to be run one time, this use effect on component mount. So that means you're going to be passing through an empty dependency array here at the end. So you'll use effect, pass through this function, and then pass through an empty dependency array. That means that it will only mount once, and will not mount on any other state changes. So the first thing you're going to do in this function is set the expire time. If you want, you can do this manually, but I'm just going to run the update expire time function so that it sets it to 5 seconds from when you log in. And then I'm going to set four event listeners. So you're going to set event listeners for click, key press, scroll, and mouse move. And you can do that with whatever events you want. Those are the events that I use. I think that encompasses pretty much every single action that a user can take. So any action that a user will take will fall usually under one of these four events. And then don't forget to clean up. So what you're gonna have to do here is return a function that removes for those event listeners from the window, just like this. And this cleans up the event listeners here. Great, so that's pretty much that entire function. These lines right here are going to, oh, by the way, for all these event listeners, do not forget to pass through the function update expire time. So when any of these events occur, it's going to call this callback function here, the update expire time, and it will update the expire time to 5 seconds from that point that event happens. Perfect. So this will update the expire time in the local storage. Now we're going to look at what to do with that expire time in the local storage. So what we're going to do is we're going to set an interval. So this is an interval. If you've ever used a set timeout, a set interval is very similar. So a set timeout, you put a certain number of milliseconds and it waits that long until it actually runs whatever function is being determined. For a set interval, it's going to do it every 5. So say you use 5 seconds here, instead of running it, waiting 5 seconds and running it once, it's going to run it every 5 seconds. So this function here is going to be run every 5 seconds. So you're going to set a new interval. You have to set it equal to a variable. So I use const interval equals set interval. And inside this function here, I'm going to check for inactivity. And I'm going to do it every 5 seconds. So every 5 seconds, we're checking for inactivity. Again, you're usually going to want to have this set to a much lower number than the expire time, but I have them both at very low numbers. Actually, let's set this to 1 second just for demonstration purposes. So now, every 1 second is going to check for inactivity and see if the expire time has been passed by the current time. Great, and then you're going to return a clear interval. So this is a built-in function of set interval. So on return, you're going to return a function. I return an error function here that clears the interval. So you're going to pass in the variable name that you established and set the set interval to, and pass it into clear interval. This stops the interval. And that is pretty much all there is to it. So let's run through it one more time really quickly. So you have two functions, check for inactivity and update expire time. So check for inactivity is going to take the expire time from the local storage and check and see if the current time has passed that expire time. The update expire time updates that expire time to however many seconds or minutes or days, whatever it is, however much time you want to pass between the last activity and the current time. So basically, on any activity, it's going to update the expired time to a certain period in the future, past that specific time, and set it to the local storage. Now you're going to call those functions in update expire time on. So you're going to set a use effect that sets event listeners on whatever events you want to count as activity, and on each of those events, you're going to update the expire time or run the update expire time function to indicate there has been activity by the user. And then you're going to have one last use effect. Oop, don't know what I did there. And one last use effect, the set at interval for however many seconds. I suggest 1 to 5 seconds. And during that interval, so for me, it's going to be 1 second. So every 1 second, you're going to run the check for inactivity function, and that function is going to determine whether to log the user out or not. So every 1 second, you're going to determine if the user has had any activity in the required amount of time. And then again, you're just going to clear this interval on return. And so that's it. Let's take one more look at it. I'll go back to Chrome here and I'll refresh, and you can see we're logged in. And if I go over to application on any of the actions I'm doing here, you can see the expire time updating. I'll do a key press. There it goes. And then if I wait and have no activity, hands off, logged in should turn to false. Perfect. Within 5 seconds, it does. So there it is. Logged in false. I hope this video helps you. I hope this video helps you determine inactivity on the user's end and detect it. And if it does, great. Thanks again for watching.